Hi, I'm Megan Campion.
And I'm Gabby Hewitt.
Gabby and I share a unique perspective. We're both former middle school teachers. We're both current parents. Gabby's children are at the very beginning of their academic career, whereas my children are approaching the end of theirs. And we're both ongoing thought partners with school and district leaders as they navigate through times that none of us could have predicted.
Today, we'd like to spend some time talking to you about how to strengthen the relationship between parents and families, or the grown-ups at school and the grown-ups at home.
Remember, this is new for you. This is new for your students and for their caretakers. We're all doing something for the first year this year. To help you with this transition, we have three tips that you can use to connect with your students' grown-ups at home.
Tip number one, consider how parents and families want to receive communication. We've all been there. We send out a text message only to have the person that we were texting call us back, or vice versa. And with so many methods to communicate, we've developed our own preferences on how we like to share information and how we prefer to receive it. Rather than rely on our own communication preferences as parents, family members, or teachers, we like to employ something called the 3x3 rule, sharing the information you want seen and heard three times in three different ways. For example, you could send out a survey asking families to share their communication preferences. And then, when you have an important announcement, you can employ all three of those communication channels to share that message widely. You can send out an email with a full message, you can send out a text message with a reminder to check email, and you can print the entire message and send it on a paper home. This ensures that families feel well supported by your communication outreach efforts and that important information is seen and heard.
Tip number two is to consider how often communication will go out and be transparent and consistent about it. Establishing a routine of consistent communication will help alleviate anxiety and keep you, your students, and their caregivers in a more proactive state that will help with continuous learning. One of the things we're all living through right now is an increased sense of uncertainty, and transparency and consistency in communication is something you can do to make your students feel more certain and their caregivers feel like they have some predictability in what's going to happen. So pick a day and a format to share the important information. Make sure you're delivering the message through your family's preferred channels, and then be consistent.
Tip number three, consider offering both structured and unstructured office hours. Office hours aren't just for parent-teacher conference night anymore. Parent-teacher office hours can actually serve two purposes. They can be used as open time for parents and families to connect with teachers, or they can be opportunities for teachers to share formal instructional advice to parents and families who are newly adapting to remote learning at home. First, decide what the purpose of your office hours is. Do you want open time for parents and families to communicate anything that is top of mind for them? Or do you want to spend the time in a more structured format, providing tips for breaking down a mini lesson at home? Once you've decided on the purpose of your office hours, use a combination of tip number one and tip number two. Share the office hour time slots using the 3x3 rule, and ensure that you're communicating those time slots in regular, anticipated intervals.
We hope these ideas for strengthening the partnership between teachers and families are helpful as you create new memories for your students this year. To recap, you want to consider how families want to receive communication, when to send consistent updates, and offering structured and unstructured office hours. We hope these tips are helpful. Let us know what strategies you're using at home, and follow us for more in the Parent Support series from Education Elements.